I realize that some of you are very tired. Now, plus, if you are seriously revising your work for the exam or your common test and you are tired this time, if you are busy playing computer games and busy looking at your phone, that is not fine. Okay? Do you understand what I'm saying? Okay, alright now. I'm going to go to the triangles. The first property of triangle is angle, sum of triangle. Angle sum of triangle is sum to what? 180 degrees. And number two is exterior angle of triangle. These are the two that I've given, and also given you a third one that is called base angles isosceles triangle. These are the three properties of triangles, right? And I've given you exercise 11A. Right? Let's go through 11A. Let's talk exercise. If I forget to let's check the answers, please let me know. I have a tendency to see that again. Okay, I'm going to go through the questions. If I'm already done in class because it's fine, if I have not, I have not raised your hand. As usual, some people cannot get used to my routine still, though it's already July. Okay? I will ask if there's anything wrong with the question. If there's less than 5, I will not do it. You will still have it in. Okay, page 289. Question 6. Is it right? Any problem? No. Question 7B. 7B. 8A. 8A. 9B. 9B. 13. 13. Is that the last one? Yeah. Yeah. Corrections. So, only Damon is not here today. Melvin went back. So I should have 37, am I right? Is this correct? Yes. Okay, first of all, 37. Okay. So, this is called angle sum of it must be parallel. Now next. Opposite sides are equal in length. I think in primary school you know, right? This is equal to this, this is equal to this. Okay? Then all four angles are right angles. Okay? Now this is important. Diagonals. Diagonals are these. AC and BD. They are called diagonals. They join the opposite vertex. Understand? Okay? So the two diagonals are equal in length. Do you agree? And diagonals bisect each other, that is A equals to EC and B equals to B. What do you bisect? This is the word that we understand. Bisect means to cut into two equal parts. Two equal parts. Okay, now what do we mean by that? Now, that means this line AC and this line BD, they are the same in length in the first place. Okay? And this side is equal to this side. And this side is equal to this side. This side equals to. Okay, but because it's a rectangle, do you all agree that all the four sides are actually equal? No? Okay, so bisect means if I'm a straight line, a line like that, when I said this line bisect this line, that means these two are the same. Okay? But if I have like that, bisect, this one means it's bisect but it's also what? Perpendicular. This one is bisect but it's not perpendicular. Do you understand? If this one passes through the midpoint, what's to be my midpoint? The center of the whole line. Everybody clear? Okay, so let's take a look at this one again. The diagonals bisect each other. AE equals to EC and BE equals to EE. Everybody clear? This is a property of a rectangle. Everybody understand? Okay, next. Let's look at the square. There are two pairs of parallel lines. Parallel sides, of course. Okay. All four sides of the same length, all four angles are right angles. Everybody okay? That's right. Next. The two diagonals are equal to length. Diagonals bisect each other at right angles. That is always aligned to this. Diagonals bisect the interior angles. That is so on and so forth. Okay, what do you have there? Now, if you have a square, first thing is that the two diagonals must be the same. Okay. What is the most important thing here is that the diagonals also bisect each other at what? 90 degrees. Now, this one is not 90 now. You understand? For a rectangle, it's not 90, but for a square, it is 90. Okay. Now, because this is 90, do you agree that this is also an isosceles triangle? So this one will be 45, right? Yes. That's why the diagonal also bisect this one. 45, 45, 45, 45. Understand? Okay, but you can also prove it this way. This is 45, this is alternate angles. This one will also be 45. Okay, there are many ways to prove it. Everybody clear? Okay, that's one thing. A square is a rectangle. But a rectangle is not a square, right? A rectangle is not a square, but a is equal to this angle. Okay, so what is actually the special rule here? It's called opposite angles of parallelogram. Now there's a special way to write parallelogram. Just draw two lines. Do you agree this means parallel? Then you write GM. So it's parallelogram. Okay, you can spell also. Because sometimes you need to spell. You'll say what type of special quadrilateral it is. So it's parallelogram. Okay, go. Then who can spell parallelogram for me? Just that all the angles are right. But a rhombus is not a square. Because to qualify as a square, an isosceles triangle or an equilateral triangle?
Oh.
Why not?
Equilateral
triangle must have what? Three equal sides. How about isosceles? Only two, right? Okay, and I ask that question. Is an equilateral triangle an isosceles triangle?
Yeah.
Yes. Because you're really satisfied, is this not simple? I don't care. Am I right? Equilateral triangle, look at two sides equal. Am I right? See what I'm talking about here. Okay, so it's better. Understand? So you must know. So are you okay with rhombus? This one is the best. Nothing can clash with it. It's called a trapezium. Ah! I spent my time here. Goodness! I must leave my legs higher. This shows that I cannot do my jump. This rider on the floor also cannot jump. What about a high jump? High jump, I go there, I should knock on the floor and die. Okay, now, let's go to the trapezium. Don't talk already, huh? Now, trapezium is the best, huh? It's the best thing for you. No, it's the best thing that can ever happen. There is at least one pair of parallel sides. Okay, that's the pair of parallel sides. That's why it's called trapezium. I think you know which one in the trapezium. Okay, now, then I need to tell you a special name for one type of trapezium. Okay, no, it's not. If I have a trapezium and these two sides are equal, it's called a an isosceles trapezium because the two sides there are the same. And you can take it down. But if the level triangle two sides there are the same, it's not isosceles trapezium. Is that clear? Understand that? Because trapezium can also be like this. Understand? So, there is at least one pair of parallel sides. Everybody okay? Can or cannot? Okay. Now, next up, so this is called isosceles trapezium. Now, next we go on to this one. Nowadays, kites no longer look like that. Last time in my older days, kites look like that. Okay, there's no such thing as dragonfly kite, or not durian kite, or something like that, or not sunbun, or whatever. Don't have, like that. Now, what is a kite made out of? Everybody look up here.
Plastic.
Kite is made out of actually two isosceles triangles joined together. Is that clear? That will constitute a kite. Okay, let's take a look at the kite. The opposite sides may be parallel. This one you don't care. Sometimes they need not be parallel. Okay? There are two pairs of equal adjacent sides. Adjacent means next to each other. Oh, look up here. This and this are equal. This and this are equal. They are next to each other. But this and this are not equal. Do you understand? So this is a kite. Now, the diagonals cut each other at right angles. That means these two diagonals again cut at right angles. Understand? Now look at this diagram, please. Only this one is equal to this one. Can you see? These two, this one, this side, and this one is not the same. One is longer than the other. Can you all see? Okay, now one more thing. Do you agree that this angle will be equal to this angle?
Yeah.
And this one will be equal to this one. But these two are not the same. Can you see? Because of the length here. Can you see that? Okay, now, let's take a look. One diagonal bisects the equilateral angles. That means this one and this one is the same. This one and this one is the same. This one, they are not the same. Everybody okay? Now, then I need to say something here. A rhombus is a kite. A rhombus is a kite. Let me show you.
It is.
Because I have all four sides equal. And the diagonal, I said 90, right? But a kite is not a rhombus. Okay. Understand? Just like gyrus is not with what? Because J or whatever. Okay, donut and taco is not the same. Okay, don't say I want to go and buy a taco. What's a taco? You should know what? You are very clever.
It's the same thing.
It's the same thing. Okay, to him it's the same thing, but it's not
the same thing with
different
dog.
I repeat, a rhombus is a kite, but a kite is not a
rhombus.
Okay, so this is basically what we have here. And the two things that you must know for this is angle sum of what? Opposite. pass.
Yes.
It's not angle bisector. It's bisector angle. The angle is being bisector. Angle bisector means another thing.
It's
a line. I know. I will teach you later, okay?
Yes.
Okay. Step back. utilize on AB such that angle AB is 9. Calculate angle ABC. Now, ABC is this one, right? You all agree? Okay, can? All got your piece? This is how you do that. Now, do you agree that these two add up to 180 degrees? So, angle ABC is 180 minus 64 degrees. Interior angles parallel like this. Alright, so this will become 116.
Okay,
so angle AED want to complete this one. Okay? Now, because it is a rhombus, do you agree that this angle here is also 68, right? Am I right? So, angle BBC is also 68 because it's a trisector angle. Okay, now, if this line is 68, can you see that I can get DCB straight away? Interior angles give us 180 degrees. Alright, so angle DCB will be 180 minus 68 minus 68. Interior angles, parallel lines. 40? 4 degrees. Very good. I might be doing a slightly different from the next one. Okay. So 44 degrees. Okay, good. Now, next. Angle DAB. This one. DAB. Now, will you agree this is opposite angles to a parallelogram? A rhombus is a parallelogram. Okay. So, angle DAB is just 44 degrees, right?
Wednesday and A to H. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Alright, stop the video.